the session of City Council Redevelopment Successor Agency Finance Authority Regular Meeting. Can we have a call to order, roll call?
Mayor Pacheco?
Here.
Councilmember Hodge?
Here.
Councilmember Romero?
Here.
Councilmember Arola Fernandez?
Here.
We have a quorum, Mayor?
Thank you. We have an audience today. Buenas tardes. Tenemos la tema de Santo Tomás después, pero si gustan hablar sobre ese tema ahorita, tenemos otras, otro negocio que tratar. Si queremos, tomamos tiempo y oír 15 minutos sobre lo que quieren y después en la junta regular seguimos con eso. ¿Está bien? Ok. Did you fill out any?
I have nothing, sir.
We didn't fill out the speaker forms, Mr. Dale, so we just allow them to come up. Okay, okay. Lo que vamos a hacer es, si gustan, llegar al micrófono y nomás dinos sus nombres, donde viven y lo que tienen pensado decir. Okay?
Good evening. My name is Omar Bomar, and I'm a resident of Calexico, 2465A Zuniga Court. I am a vendor, like all my partners and friends in Calexico, and I'm here to speak a little bit about the difficulties that we have had personally as a family business. We have been in the business since 1993 in Santo Tomas. And since the incident, we've had many hardships loading and unloading the merchandise on a daily basis. And I speak, I can take it, but for my mother, it would be too much to bear. My mother has breast cancer and myodysplasia. Myodysplasia, MDS, is a blood disorder. She cannot produce red blood cells. Her bone marrow is not functioning and cannot produce red blood cells. And the physical labor involved in loading and unloading merchandise on a daily basis in Santo Tomas has become a challenge for her. As a result, we cannot continue to work on a daily basis. It is, she cannot perform that. It is my parents' only source of income, and we are desperate and seek your help. We are willing to abide to all the regulations of the city, but we need your support. We are here with my fellow. This is just one of the 230 full-time businessmen and women at Santo Tomas and are here to express our challenges that we have heard from the city. We would like the city to empathize and understand our daily challenges. Thank you.
Thank you. Omar, thank you. Long time no see.
Thank you, Mr. Pacheco. Thank you for your time, ladies and gentlemen.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Otra persona, somebody else?
Buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Pedro Ortiz, residente de la ciudad de Calexico, 1316 Sunlight. Yo vengo en representación de mis compañeros, soy alguna de las personas que estamos representando, somos tres en particular, y vengo a exponer un punto en particular. El punto a exponer ante ustedes es que nos están exigiendo para poder trabajar, okay, descargar y cargar nuestras mercancías diario, lo cual no vemos como una opción viable, porque nos genera un desgaste físico y económico, y no es factible hacerlo, hacer eso, no es factible para nosotros hacerlo. He investigado y no he encontrado ningún código que nos reglamente, que nos exija que tengamos que descargar y cargar. Y es algo que la mayoría de nuestros compañeros no puede hacer. ¿Okay? Nosotros entendemos ahora que soy muy optimista, nos abra el Santo Tomás. Entendemos que hay cosas que hacer, estamos de acuerdo. Entendemos que lo más importante es la seguridad de las personas y nosotros como vendedores. Y nosotros como vendedores tenemos una propuesta. Una propuesta que, claro, se va a llevar a cabo después de que se resuelva abrir el Santo Tomás. El que nos permitan trabajar y de poner nuestras mercancías a exhibir todos los días y nosotros levantar un día, el martes, como opción para que ustedes ejerzan su trabajo de supervisar tanto bomberos como building, construcción. El que ninguna persona haga alguna construcción no adecuada, ¿ok? Entonces, y ustedes en particular, por ejemplo, ese uno que es mi espacio, no puedes abrir porque estás modificando lo acordado y no vas a abrir hasta que dejes las cosas en condiciones como está acordado. Pero una área en particular, al vendedor, como nos están cobrando como vendedores individualmente, a ese vendedor que no está cumpliendo el reglamento, se le cancele temporalmente su permiso para vender, para que ustedes tengan la opción de hacer su trabajo y nosotros tengamos la seguridad. Esa es una opción que nosotros proponemos como vendedores. Pero el que nos estén generando ustedes, que nos estén exigiendo levantar diario, es algo que no es aceptable para nosotros, y más cuando no es un código, es algo que ustedes están decidiendo hacer, y aparte cuando no lo están exigiendo a todas las personas, nada más están siendo exclusivamente con el Santo Tomás. Entonces, si es un código que no lo es, no lo encontré, ¿por qué no lo aplican en todos lados? Nada más lo están aplicando en el Santo Tomás. Eso es lo que yo no sé, y eso es lo que quisiera que me aclararan. Ese es mi punto. Nosotros somos un grupo de personas que somos residentes de Calexico. Nosotros somos un grupo de personas que somos votantes de Calexico. Nosotros tenemos más de mes y medio que no estamos laborando a nuestras condiciones para cubrir nuestros gastos, ¿ok? Y no nos han dado una solución viable. A mi punto de vista, están tapando un hoyo y están abriendo otro. Ese no es mi punto de vista. Necesito que me expliquen cuál es la solución, porque no me han dado una solución a mi trabajo. Señores, la intención de nosotros no es nada más que trabajar, ¿okay? En unas condiciones que nos sea viable, que tengamos una forma de competir, porque todo lo que nos ocasione, tanto cargar o descargar, me genera un gasto físico y económico, el cual no me permite competir con el otro, con mi competencia, porque me genera más gasto, y eso lo voy a cobrar en mi producto que estoy exhibiendo.
Gracias, señor Ortiz, gracias. Gracias.
¿Otra persona?
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es César Figueroa y también soy uno de los representantes de los vendedores del Santo Tomás. Voy a ser breve. Santo Tomás es un referente para las personas que visitan esta ciudad de Calexico, puesto que sus vendedores les ofrecen una gama de artículos usados y nuevos a precios muy bajos, y es fuente de importantes empleos directos, puesto que tiene vendedores arriba de 50 años de edad, que son trabajador y dueño a la vez. Lo maravilloso de esto, señores, es que no son carga para el gobierno, sino que también son pilar importante para la economía de esta ciudad, porque pagan impuestos y servicios. Por otra parte, Santo Tomás es una fuente importante para la economía de los negocios que operan en esta ciudad. En pocas palabras, es un efecto dominó, porque las personas que van a comprar a Santo Tomás generan una importante derrama económica en esta ciudad, porque consumen gasolina, compran comida y muchas otras cosas. Si lo consideran así, si no lo consideran así, aquí traemos, tenemos firmas donde muchos negocios de la ciudad de Calexico nos apoyan, y también de muchos ciudadanos de Calexico que están a favor de que se abra el SWATMI. En lo personal, mi negocio es un negocio de generaciones. Primero mis suegros, luego mis hijos. Primero mis suegros, luego yo, luego mis hijos, ¿verdad? Es un negocio de terceras generaciones. Hablando claro, el comercio de Calexico no tiene una economía propia o cautiva, puesto que depende en un 90% de Mexicali, México. Por eso es que el SWATMI Santo Tomás necesita una, bueno, más bien los vendedores de SWATMI necesitamos una respuesta positiva para la petición que hacemos de que se abra, que autoricen que se abra, porque no podemos estar sin laborar, ¿verdad? Gracias.
Gracias.
Bueno, gracias. Una persona más y vamos a oírlo, y después tenemos que tomar temas del negocio aquí. Juan Carlos.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Juan Carlos González, 1110 Rosas Street, Calexico, California. Vengo fundamentalmente en representación de la oficina del Santo Tomás y por invitación de los vendedores, porque me siento en la obligación moral y real de respaldarlos. Nosotros recibimos una última carta de parte del staff técnico de la ciudad de Calexico con una serie de requisitos para poder reanudar nuestras operaciones regulares. Estamos en el proceso de responder, la debemos de hacer de manera cuidadosa, porque hay una serie de requisitos de carácter económico y necesitamos ver su factibilidad y la posibilidad de retorno. Finalmente, el Santo Tomás es un negocio y finalmente tiene que ser sustentable. Y la invitación a la que respondo con los vendedores es la preocupación fundamental, porque es una exigencia que debemos de funcionar con esa condición en que los vendedores deben cargar y descargar todos los días, ¿sí? Que, como dicen los compañeros, resulta costosa, onerosa, tanto física como materialmente, ¿sí? Y se empalma con un interés en ese punto con los vendedores de parte de nosotros, porque estamos exigidos la parte de querer reanudar nuestras operaciones con una inversión que nos ha sido más o menos establecida en un rango cuantioso. Y yo creo que la propuesta, toda propuesta que venga del staff técnico y de la ciudad debe ser pro negocio, es decir, que sea viable, que sea sustentable. Y es en donde nos empalmamos un interés con los vendedores, porque si hay una forma selectiva de aplicar algún criterio que nos reste competitividad en la industria, aquí mismo en Calexico, sí resulta un desafío posiblemente insuperable tanto para los vendedores como para nosotros. ¿Sí? Esa es una parte humana y económica que debemos atender, y por eso estoy en este caso atendiendo una invitación de ellos, cuando básicamente esta era una convocatoria de los vendedores para los vendedores, expresando una inquietud. ¿Sí? Así que nosotros estamos apelando a, y como yo establecí un compromiso con los vendedores, queremos reanudar las operaciones del Santo Tomás, ¿sí?, en condiciones que sean razonables, ¿sí?, desde el punto de vista de ejecución, y sobre todo que sean sustentables y factibles desde el punto de vista económico. Esa es una tarea que el Santo Tomás tiene que tomar, pero también tiene que tomar la parte complementaria que tiene que ver con los vendedores. ¿Sí? Queremos preservar 44 años de tradición, queremos preservar, tenemos 15 empleos de tiempo completo nosotros, 200 empleos que son de economías de autosustentables de los vendedores, y los empleos indirectos que se generan de ello. ¿Sí? Además, como externan algunos de los compañeros vendedores, necesitamos preservar un ecosistema completo que no solo atañe al Santo Tomás, sino que se complementa con una serie de negocios complementarios. ¿Sí? Haremos cualquier cosa, ¿sí?, para preservar no solo la tradición, ¿sí?, sino una economía, ¿sí?, complementaria, ¿sí?, en todos los niveles, en donde nosotros formamos parte de un eslabón. ¿Sí? Mi principal inquietud, ¿sí?, que es la que he querido externar, es que esto tiene que llevarse a cabo en términos justos, ¿sí?, y cuando me refiero a justos, me refiero exclusivamente a que sean competitivos y no selectivos. ¿Sí? Parte de la queja de que yo la tomo como propia de los vendedores es que ciertos códigos, ordenanzas, sugerencias se apliquen de forma selectiva, ¿sí?, para la misma industria. ¿Sí? Es una preocupación para nosotros que probablemente no se lleve a cabo así. Es una cosa que nos preocupa, porque si vamos a hacer una inversión y no vamos a competir en igualdad de condiciones, va a ser difícil para ellos y para nosotros la supervivencia. Muy amables por su atención.
Juan Carlos, gracias.
Gracias.
Ahora sí vamos a tener que cerrar esta parte de la junta, y tenemos negocios que hacer en closed session, en sesión cerrada. So vamos a dejar aquí y regresamos, y después, si gustan tomar más tiempo con esto, regresamos a este tema. Okay? We're gonna return to the meeting and go to closed session. We're back. Sí, hablamos un poco sobre el tema y les tenemos información, y después discutimos con ustedes si quieren hablar un poquito más, ¿ok? Señor Figueroa. Sí.
Como parte de lo que se ha venido comentando, lo que escuchamos por parte de ustedes, antes de entrar en sesión cerrada, las inquietudes, las preguntas, la decisión que se tomó en este momento por el concilio es ofertar a todos los comerciantes de Santo Tomás un foro público donde tengan la oportunidad de poder hacernos saber cuáles son sus inquietudes, sus preguntas, aclarar todo, la presencia del concilio, de la administración, del jefe de bomberos y las agencias que también están siendo parte del proceso que se lleva a cabo. Como sabemos, para poder tener un foro de 300 o más personas, se ocupa tener una ubicación apta para ello. Entonces, vamos a trabajar de ser posible con nuestros vecinos de San Diego State para poder utilizar el teatro que tiene la capacidad para recibir a todos los vendedores de Santo Tomás y las personas que vengan con ustedes para tener la oportunidad de atender cada una de sus preguntas y dudas. De la misma forma, estamos poniendo como fecha límite el jueves 31 de enero para que de antemano, si gustan, nos puedan hacer llegar esas preguntas que ustedes tengan para poder estar organizados el 4 de febrero y poder atenderlos de la manera más adecuada. En este momento, como sabemos, y si ustedes tuvieron la oportunidad de ver la agenda del día de hoy, no es un tema que esté dentro de la agenda. Eso nos limita a nosotros y al concilio de poder tomar determinaciones o extenderse más en el tema. Entonces, les queremos comunicar esto para estar en sintonía, que todos sepamos del porqué de las cosas. Ustedes tienen el derecho de, en este momento, si gustan seguir dar su comentario público de 3 minutos, lo pueden hacer. Nosotros es importante primero dar este testimonio de lo que se está proponiendo para el 4 de febrero, para que sea el conocimiento de todos ustedes y sus compañeros que no tuvieron la oportunidad de estar aquí, lo puedan hacer ese día también. Simplemente para aclarar las cosas, y ese día yo creo que también es adecuado proporcionarles los documentos públicos, porque a fin de cuentas son documentos públicos, ¿no? Las cuestiones que se han intercambiado entre la ciudad y Santo Tomás, para que de alguna manera también de esa forma todos estemos informados, los comerciantes tengan la misma información que se ha estado manejando. Entonces, eso básicamente es la dirección que nos dio el concilio para compartir hacia ustedes. Antes de que el alcalde Pacheco tome la palabra, les quiero hacer un anuncio. El día de hoy, la Oficina del Pequeño Negocio Federal declaró como un estado de desastre lo sucedido en Santo Tomás, y esto, por firma del gobernador de California, da la oportunidad de que se abran otro tipo de préstamos diferentes a los cuales ustedes ya tienen conocimiento. Entonces, comparto esto, la noticia se hizo oficial el día de hoy. Hoy fue la firma del gobernador ante esto, y esto abre que la Oficina del Pequeño Negocio Federal pueda ofertar otros servicios para todos los comerciantes, los ciudadanos afectados y de la misma manera también los propietarios del inmueble. Van a venir más detalles que vamos a compartir nosotros acerca de estas oportunidades. Lo que les quiero adelantar es de que las personas, los compañeros de la agencia que van a estar trabajando uno a uno con ustedes, van a estar operando dentro de las oficinas de la ciudad. Detalles sobre esto lo van a ver próximamente. Vamos a encontrar la manera también de difundirlo dentro de los comerciantes de Santo Tomás para que estén enterados, ¿no? Por mi parte, señor Pacheco, es mi comentario.
Bueno. Ahora vamos a abrir unos comentarios, pero como tenemos una agenda regular, les vamos a dar unas 4 personas, porque ya sabemos que es el propósito de estar aquí ustedes, ¿verdad? Sabemos el motivo.
Ese va a estar sujeto nada más a las personas damnificadas, o va a ser en general a todos los vendedores, porque todos a final de cuentas fuimos afectados ya ante esta situación de que no se había.
Con gusto les puedo leer el comunicado oficial que salió donde dice low interest federal disaster loans are available to California businesses and residents affected by the Santo Tomas fire that occurred December 8, 2018. Sigue obviamente el comunicado, pero aquí claramente lo que está señalando es que este programa va a ser para todos aquellos afectados por el siniestro y específicamente menciona negocios, residentes y comerciantes del incendio de Santo Tomás. Pero en referente a la pregunta que hace el señor Ortiz, existe el mapa de proyecto autorizado de 1992, donde determina exactamente el uso que tiene un swap meet. Si me da oportunidad nomás de comentarle lo siguiente, si gusta, lo que podemos hacer es podemos dialogar este tema al final de la junta, o si gustan algunos representantes de nosotros podemos salir aquí para no detener la junta y poder dar respuesta a lo que usted comenta. Como le comento, se los está proponiendo la ciudad, si gusta para ver ese tema en específico, lo podemos dialogar ahorita.
Buenas noches. Oiga, en la a todos, y no soy la única, somos muchas, muchas señoras mayores que están haciendo también, descargando y cargando. Yo les pido, ya la desesperación que traemos muchas personas, muchas señoras, yo no entiendo de política, yo no entiendo nada. Nosotros queremos trabajar, trabajar, porque ya estamos atrasados en todo, se los pido por favor, en nombre de todas mis compañeras, señoras mayores, señores mayores, se lo pedimos, por favor, apóyenos, ayúdenos. En otras partes están bien, no cargan y no descargan. ¿Por qué nos ponen a hacer eso nosotros? Lloviendo, vientos, los fríazos que han estado haciendo, así hemos estado todos, porque tenemos hambre, necesidad de trabajar. No pasamos una buena Navidad. Disculpe que me ponga así, pero esto ya es desesperante para nosotros. Nos duele la espalda, nos duele, cansados, estamos cansados, y se lo pido, se lo suplico, ayúdenos, ayúdenos. Nosotros Santo Tomás somos puras personas trabajadoras, que no vivimos de nadie más que de nuestro trabajo, gente honrada, trabajadora. Disculpe que me ponga así, pero esto ya es desesperante, nos están pidiendo más tiempo. ¿Usted cree que a mí van a pedir, me van a dar, mi rentero me va a dar tiempo ya? Ya no me va a dar tiempo, no sé, esto es un papel que ya tengo días nomás para mi renta. Esto es puro vueltas, vueltas, ya tenemos un mes aquí y no miramos, no miramos cuándo nos vayan a solucionar. Disculpe que me ponga así, pero este es el de todos mis compañeros. Muchas gracias.
Gabriela, gracias.
Mi nombre es Humberto García, tengo 50 años y creo que soy el más chico de todos. Estoy dañado de la espalda. Mucha gente aquí es gente mayor que está discapacitada y aún así está trabajando. No está en servicios sociales, no está pidiendo ayudas, lo único que está queriendo es trabajar. Esto es lo que pide, no está pidiendo nada más. Lo mismo pedirían ustedes si estuvieran en la misma situación que nosotros. Nomás que nos dejen trabajar, es todo, no pedimos más. No sé si quieran que vayamos a servicios sociales, somos 300 familias que vivimos de esto, que estamos dañados. Si ustedes ven a la gente que vino aquí, es porque la otra de plano no pudo venir, es gente muy mayor, que tiene que trabajar todos los días, no pueden bajar ni subir todos los días, es gente que a duras penas se puede mover. Créanme que si yo me dedico a esto, es porque en Calexico no hay trabajo. Si ustedes me dieran trabajo, créanme, yo pero no hay trabajo que hacer. Tengo 30, tenemos 40 años en esto nosotros. Mi papá trabajaba en eso. Mi papá me quiso dar una educación para que yo no me dedicara a eso, que me dedicara a otra cosa. Pero ¿qué creen? Yo soy de Calexico, aquí vivo. Me gusta estar aquí, me gusta estar en la ciudad. Lo mismo le propuse a mi hijo, que estudiara. Pero él quiere estar en Calexico, le gusta Calexico. No hay trabajo, se está dedicando también. ¿Qué va a pasar? Okay. La gente de aquí, como digo, muchos de ellos están discapacitados y la gente que no pudo venir es porque plano no pudo venir. Así de fácil. Miren, muchos perdieron todo lo que tenían, lo perdieron en el incendio. Los que no lo pidieron, perdieron con el incendio, lo perdieron cuando apagaron el incendio. Y los que no, lo perdieron con el tiempo que tenemos sin trabajar. Así de fácil. Mire, lo único que les pedimos es eso. Eso que está escrito ahí atrás. Es lo único que les pedimos. Que no dejen trabajar. Juntos. No ustedes y nosotros no. No, juntos nomás. Es lo que queremos. Yo no sé si sepan, pero la economía de Calexico depende enteramente de Mexicali. No está viniendo gente de Mexicali, no está viniendo a comprar acá, porque mucha gente que venía, venía en fin de semana a Santo Tomás. Miércoles a Palmas, pues la gente ya no está viniendo el fin de semana. Eso se está afectando a los otros negocios de Calexico, me está afectando a mí personalmente, me está afectando a todos. Lo único que pedimos es eso, no pedimos más. Es todo lo que pedimos más, que nos dejen trabajar.
Humberto, gracias.
Otra persona. Dos comentarios más para...
Buenas noches. Buenas noches, mi nombre es Laura Herrera, tengo 22 años vendiendo en Santo Tomás Oatmeat. Hace 15 días que hubo la otra reunión, fuimos pocas personas las que venimos y entre ellas yo participé, les comenté lo que estaba pasando. Pasaron otros 15 días más y hasta ahorita no tenemos una respuesta. Estoy de acuerdo con todo lo que mis compañeros están diciendo y con el debido respeto que ustedes me merecen, les voy a decir lo siguiente. Afortunadamente, ustedes tuvieron la oportunidad de estudiar, tienen el idioma, tienen los medios y están percibiendo un sueldo, el cual nosotros no tenemos ahorita. Entonces, yo quisiera de la manera más atenta decirles que se pongan a pensar un poquito en nosotros, ¿sí? Y le den a Santo Tomás las condiciones justas para que ellos no batallen y puedan volver a abrir lo que es Santo Tomás. Porque si ellos no pueden, porque las condiciones que ustedes les ponen no las pueden ajustar, nosotros nos vamos a quedar sin trabajo. Y no nada más nosotros, como están diciendo todos los compañeros, dependen de nosotros, otras personas, somos bastantes familias. Entonces, si va a haber una junta el día 4, yo creo que a todos nos gustaría que ese día nos den una decisión, nos digan sí o no, pero en ese momento. No queremos estar esperando más porque no podemos esperar más. Queremos trabajar y hemos estado la mayoría por más de 20 años trabajando. Entonces, es muy difícil que de la noche a la mañana se te vaya tu forma de trabajo, lo que único que sabes hacer, y que todavía te pongan condiciones para que no puedas seguir trabajando. Entonces, por favor, ayúdenos y hagan lo mejor posible para que nosotros podamos continuar trabajando. Gracias.
Gracias, Laura. One more person, please. Otra persona ahí.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es Alberto Albizu. Soy de... miembros del concilio a que conozcan las historias de cada uno de los vendedores de Santo Tomás y escuchen sus razones. En su mayoría son adultos mayores que rebasan los 50 años de edad. Muchos de ellos, a causa de lesiones y de su avanzada, se les complica el sistema que ahora se les quiere imponer, que es el de bajar, subir mercancía en sus espacios todos los días. La mayoría de ellos tienen más de 20 años trabajando en Santo Tomás, y la manera que ellos realizaban sus actividades de trabajo hacía más ligera su carga, la cual consistía en tener mercancía que exhibieran todos los días en sus espacios. Tengo una lista de cartas de algunos de mis compañeros comerciantes que escribieron con su puño y letra, en la cual comparten su situación y cómo están siendo afectados. Me encantaría que ustedes, miembros del concilio, se tomaran el tiempo de leerlas, y creo firmemente a ver las cosas desde nuestra perspectiva. De esta forma, les hago una invitación pública para que se den un tiempo y conozcan a cada una de las personas que forman parte de la comunidad de vendedores de Santo Tomás, para que conozcan sus preocupaciones, sus dolores y el gran esfuerzo que hacen el día a día para salir adelante. Para ustedes, para algunos de ustedes, fue fácil decidir y dar la orden de cerrar todo por lo que sucedió, sin antes acercarse a nosotros y darse cuenta del impacto de toda esta situación que está causando toda esta situación. Los efectos han sido más negativos que positivos en nuestras familias, en nuestra ciudad, para nuestros compañeros comerciantes y para la enorme cantidad de clientes que asisten diariamente a Santo Tomás y que en su mayoría vienen de Cali. Entendemos que las cosas no serán como antes y que la prioridad número uno es la seguridad del público y la nuestra, y estamos comprometidos a eso. Santo Tomás Oatmeat es un lugar de mucha tradición y ha hecho historia en la ciudad de Calexico, así como con nuestros vecinos de Mexicali, y nosotros los comerciantes también somos parte de esa historia. Solo hay que ver a nuestro alrededor, en las familias de los comerciantes de Santo Tomás somos segunda y tercera generación. Yo, en lo personal, soy segunda generación de comerciantes de mi familia. Somos familias trabajadores que no les pide nada a nadie, solo el derecho de trabajar y seguir forjando un mejor futuro para nuestras familias y al mismo tiempo a nuestra ciudad. Queremos que esta historia continúe por muchos años. Por lo tanto, les pido aquí y ahora que ustedes, distinguidos miembros del concilio, que nos permitan continuar con nuestro trabajo de la manera que solíamos hacerlo, pero esta vez con un mejor sistema de trabajo y, claro, dándole prioridad a los códigos de seguridad. Muchas gracias.
Gracias, Alberto. Vamos a tener la opción de tener esta junta en un lugar amplio para tener a ustedes todos en presente. Vamos a, si quieren, are you going to get the documentation?
We're gonna.
Y tenemos programado el día, el 4 de febrero, a ver si se consigue este auditorium para tener todos ahí presente. Y si pueden, entreguen sus preguntas, detalles, lo que piensan, como hoy, este problema de bajar y subir, quitar, meter, es ese detallito también. Y tendremos las respuestas ese día, por seguro, ese día tener las respuestas, para no extender este problema más con más tiempo. So, ese es el plan, tener la junta el 4 de febrero en un lugar bastante amplio para tener a ustedes presentes para que dejen sus problemas que piensan que está ahorita como demasiado muy pesado para ustedes, y tendremos una respuesta para ustedes. ¿Sí? Bueno, gracias. Gracias por llegar y dar sus opiniones y sus quejas. No hay problema. Aquí estamos para eso. Los esperamos el día 4, y si pueden dejar sus preguntas el día 31 aquí en las oficinas, dejen nomás, quiero esto, la respuesta es esta, quiero, mi problema es esta. So, si hay una lista de detalles de que tienen de problemas, para tener unas respuestas para ustedes. ¿Okay? ¿Sí? Yo diré que trabajan hasta las 5, ¿qué les parece? 5 y media o 6?
6.
¿Mejor las 6 o las 5 y media? ¿Las 6? ¿Las 6?
6.
Ok. Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí y dejar sus, problemitas y quejas del trabajo. Gracias por llegar. Thank you for coming. We're going to take a 5-minute break so we can get reorganized. 5 minutes, 5-minute break. Agency Calexico Financing Authority regular session agenda. Call to order, please. Roll call.
Mayor Pacheco.
Here.
Councilmember Hodge.
Here.
Councilmember Romero.
Here.
Councilmember Arreola Fernandez.
Here.
We have a quorum, Mayor.
Thank you. Pledge of Allegiance. Will
you can lead it. Want me to lead it?
Yes, go ahead, Mr.
Please stand, everyone. Hand over your heart. God bless. Here we go.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Dale, mission statement.
Together, we pledge to provide effective and efficient services in a courteous and respectful manner to improve the quality of life for all in our unique border community. Viva Calexico.
Please remain standing while we have Pastor Brett Miller, Christ Community Church.
Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we recognize that you establish governments and authorities and you bring them down. You are sovereign over all that happens, so we thank you for the peace that we have here to meet and discuss beneficial and just for the people of Calexico. Lord, we pray for those who are citizens and those who are immigrants, for those who have power and for those who have none. You show no favoritism, and you plead the cause of the helpless. So now, Lord, in this time, we ask for wisdom to govern among the conflicting interests and issues of our times. We pray for a sense of welfare and the true needs of the people. We pray that there would be a keen thirst for justice and rightness. We ask for confidence in what is good and fitting and the ability to work together in harmony even when there is honest disagreement. We pray for personal peace in the lives of the council members here and joy in the task ahead of them. We pray that decisions made here are honoring and reflective of the coming reign of Jesus Christ and those that would reflect the kingdom of God, where the oppressed become free, the blind can see, and that prosperity will come to Calexico, social prosperity, economic prosperity, moral prosperity, and ultimately prosperity with God through Jesus. We pray for the agenda set here today. We pray for the situation with the San Tomas fires. Pray that there can be just restoration and goodwill on all sides. And we pray that there would be clarity in that decision. We bring these things before you, not according to our righteousness or our goodness or our morality, but because of our faith in Christ. We pray these things in his name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you for waiting, Pastor.
No worries.
I'm sorry. Move along to closed session announcements. Any announcements?
No reportable actions taken.
Thank you. Moving on, approval of the agenda.
I'll make the motion to approve the agenda, Mr. Mayor.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Pass. Thank you. The clerk can read the announcements, please.
These proceedings may be viewed on the City of Calexico website at www.calexico.ca.gov the Friday following the City Council meeting. Mayor Pacheco will have community office hours to hear the concerns of the citizens the fourth Tuesday of the month from 5:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. at City Hall in the City Manager's Conference Room, 608 Heber Avenue, Calexico. Public comments. This is the time for the public to address the City Council on any item not appearing on the agenda that is within the subject matter jurisdiction of the City Council. The mayor will recognize you, and when you come to the microphone, please state your name and place of residence for the record. While members of the public are encouraged to participate, it is unlawful to disturb or delay the council meeting with personal or slanderous remarks. If the item you wish to comment on is on consent, please comment now. The City Council is prohibited by state law from taking action or discussing items not included on the printed agenda. If the item you wish to comment on is a public portion of the agenda, we will take your comment when we get to the item on the agenda. Please direct your questions and comments to the City Council.
Anybody for public comments, Ms. Clerk?
Mr. Kim?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And I see in the today's lots of people that came to concern about the talking about the issues. And one thing I admire City Council to bring them here to have a meeting to talking their concerns. But this was an illegal meeting. I think the lawyer knows better. That should be posted. Five council member, more than three, has to be notified, noticed to the people to we're gonna have a meeting. It wasn't. I'm glad you guys doesn't try to do anything, but it should be on the, should be notified at the council meeting, at the, our public. So I didn't know, a lot of people didn't know. I don't know how they get the message. But what about the rest of the citizens? More than three council member meeting should notify for the public. But I'm still the admired our city council try to solve the problem. But my concern is they are working at the daily incomes and they don't have an unemployment. They cannot, if they cannot sell, that means there's no money comes in. And I believe the city has to find a way to, of course they have safety issues, but they still can, whatever way I see it, they still can have open the swami without hurting our city ordinance, probably no powers. At least it's just a regular swami, what's the differences? I believe the city has to looking into that way to let them work that makes their life support. And I'm glad I see this, some of the agenda about the federal workers. What about them? Why we can't, couldn't do them the waiver, same water rate, and even give them the time without disconnecting their waters until certain times? Why not give them the little support?
Have we disconnected water?
If they cannot pay the water.
Oh, no. Do you know if they've disconnected?
No, I don't say.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
I don't say that. You guys put in the agenda to try to help the federal workers. Why not them? So it's several small things in the city. It could help them to be surviving in that issues.
Seconds, Mr. Kim, 20 seconds.
So that's I believe we have council and cities, they can have a better idea to help them better. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kim.
Ismael Lopez?
I don't think he's in the building.
He left me some notes. I don't know, can I speak on his behalf or no? No.
Oh. Nobody else? Okay. Thank you. City Council comments, Mr. Hodge?
Yes, I have a few, sir. First of all, I want to thank administration and staff for caring and completing the City Calexico Action Plan. Very impressed with it. A lot of activities, 9 pages of projects. And so this is a good roadmap for us, for all of us. I think every council member should have one, department heads, administration, but it's the subject matter, current status, immediate objectives, long-term objectives, estimated timeline, and where the funding is coming. There's more that we could do, but I think that this is a great start, and I was told that it will be updated from time to time, most likely on a monthly basis or when it needs to be done. But my congratulations. Thank you, Mr. Dale, and the staff. I want the City of Calexico to do a proclamation for our local McDonald's. I attended the open ceremony and it was quite successful. The Calexico restaurant is the region's largest, plus the franchise owners of the Leon brothers own 9 other McDonald's in the region. Now this McDonald's here in Calexico will definitely galvanize and inspire other businesses to invest in Calexico. I think we need to honor their contributions. So I'm requesting that we invite them and do a proclamation for them, Mr. City Manager, as soon as we can or our next meeting. Okay, still waiting, but hoping to receive by next meeting the commission's template that I had recommended to all city council members. Maybe the new ones have received it. I don't have one. I'd like to have one that identifies the commissions, the members, time and date of meeting, and so forth. The next step for restoring the commissions is for all council members to receive, was told we have this, the document that explains procedures and bylaws. And I'm requesting that item be given to us if it's possible by next meeting. And one more item, and the vendors, my heart goes out to them. For a long time, Mr. Dale, I know that we didn't, for whatever reasons, didn't, correct me if I'm wrong, didn't enforce the daily loading and unloading. But because of the dire circumstances, you know, families and children are suffering, is there any way that we can temporarily put relief on enforcing the daily loading and unloading or compromise and make it only twice a week or so forth? Or are our hands tied by state mandate? Is it?
No, we need to look at that.
We need to look at that. So there's a possibility. That's good. There was a survey done by a particular company. I'll receive the absolute facts about it because I don't like to state anything without backup and research, but I was informed that 52% of all the vendors are of the age of 57 to 79 years old. And 62% vendors have, over a long period of time, business licenses and have complied with the city code. So that sort of counters a perception that a lot of people have in Calexico that they did not, for the majority, have business license. At least I've been told about that. That's all I have to report, Mr. Mayor. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hodge. Mr. Romero, anything for the council?
Just piggybacking off of Councilman Hodge, congratulating the city administration on their action plan. I had the pleasure of also taking a look at it today and seeing the updates, and they're doing an amazing job. As well, I was able to be at the grand opening of McDonald's and was able to give a couple of words on behalf of City Hall and the entire staff, and it's just great to see the great infrastructure that I've rebuilt, and nothing short of a proclamation, like Councilman Hodge mentioned, is duly noted and should be duly given to the De Leon family and its entire staff. And as you know, and off of that as well, I don't know if you guys have heard, there's a gentleman by the name of Esdras Ochoa, class of 2000 here in Calexico, who has actually been known as the Taco King in LA and is now has opened up 3 restaurants in Hong Kong, India, and Los Angeles, and was recently a semi-finalist in a Netflix called The Final Table. You know, a gentleman like him, you know, young millennial, you know, is paving the way for local Calexicans to know that, you know, you can make it happen with just a little bit of effort and going out and working hard. And I think something should be duly noted for him as well, whether it be a proclamation or a resolution. And that's pretty much it. So thank you.
Thank you.
No, I don't have anything. Thank you.
I just have one item. Mr. Dale, you and I are going to wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yes.
On Thursday to get directions to come down to Calexico and start counting our homeless population.
Friday morning. I think it's Friday morning.
Friday morning.
Yes.
We have to be there at 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yes.
We have a short in-service workshop on how to address this population, and now we're going to get, I guess, our assignments.
Yes.
Would you want to, who else is going to join us? We have 2 other gentlemen from the city.
Correct.
So there'll be a grand total of?
At least 4 of us, and there may be more, and for Calexico. And what this does is when we count the homeless, we get the number and we turn it into HUD and the state, and that in turn gets us funding for addressing these issues. So that's why we're doing it.
It's an important task, and thank you, Mr. Dale, for
offering your services. I volunteered you.
5 o'clock in the morning.
5 o'clock in the morning. Okay. Other than that, anything for the on your report there?
No, sir. Not at this time, sir. Mr. Mayor.
Nothing?
No.
Okay.
No, sir.
Mr. Mayor, I'll make a motion, if there's nothing else of what we've gone over, that we approve the consent agenda items 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Thank you. Consent agenda pass. The following items are for potential action items. Mm-hmm. Number 8. Authorize the city manager to sign agreement for professional services with Dynamic Consulting Engineers, Inc. for construction management, geotechnical, and inspection services for the Las Flores Street Improvement Federal Project number CML-5168-030. Mr. Dale, any comments?
Yeah, if you have any questions, we have our public works manager in attendance that can answer. I just like to state that I have recuse myself from making any selections on any engineering firms because I have so much experience with so many engineering firms in the Valley.
Mayor, we have a speaker. Mr. Kim.
Mr. Kim,
number eight, please. I thought the last of strip the Calexico after they graving the or they put the new asphalt or paved those street, I seen the last was larger jobs. They got all, they don't cover well under between the asphalt. And I believe we have some inspection matters. We are, or they are intention to be that way.
No, they're not finished with that project yet, sir. We had to wait until the weather warms up a little to finish the paving. So that's why.
So it's a lot of street that was there, like that, and they have left the hole. And I believe that this time we need to do a better job on the inspections, and whoever you hire. And the citizen was marking us. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Please follow me. De Las Flores Street.
Yes, good evening, Mayor and Council members. The City of Calexico was lucky enough to receive a grant from the Department of Transportation under their congestion mitigated air quality to pave an unpaved road, which is De Las Flores, between Cloak Avenue and Edie Avenue. That road right now, it's not a through road. There is a barricade on Edie and De Las Flores. But now with the funding that we're gonna be receiving, we're gonna be able to pave it, install curb, gutter, sidewalk, as well as street lights and other utilities. So we are presenting the agenda item number eight to authorize the city manager to hire Dynamic Consulting to do the construction management, geotechnic, and also inspection services. Later on agenda number 11 is to hire the actual construction company.
Chairman?
Yes.
Yeah, that street's been long overdue.
Yeah.
And I think individuals are using part of that area as a dumping ground also.
Right.
So I think we need to address the issue with fencing, and I think the sidewalk is going to help a lot of kids going to either Blanche Charles or Willie Moreno. That'll be a nice entryway into those schools, and it'll eliminate them being on Highway 98.
Right.
And I think that'll be a very good investment on our part of the city to add that street to the project. Very good. Any questions?
No. Great plan, I think, and it should alleviate the traffic in the school area, especially with Glenn Charles and William Moreno being there. So, great job.
All righty, call for the question.
Make a motion to approve item number eight, Mr. Mayor.
There a second?
Second.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. Pass. Item number nine. We're going to approve the City of Calexico 5-year plan project 2018 to 2023 for road projects to be funded by Imperial County Local Transportation Authority, LATA sales tax revenue. Ms. Falomid, you're still here.
Yes, sir.
We have a
Mr. Kim.
Senor Kim.
Again. Our City of Calexico, the water pipe and sewer system is not good. I believe everybody knows. Now in time for the 5-year plan, why don't put changing all the pipes together so we don't have to spend another money for the pave our streets. We already we have money to do those jobs. Why not do time together? That will save a lot of money and time, and citizens on convenience just for the one time they can take care of all the issues we needed. That's my concern about that.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Mr. Dale, I know we have a lot of streets here identified.
Yeah.
And if for some reason we need to look into the, of course, the tubing and the piping, and is that going to be prior to the actual work being done to the street?
Yes, and in fact, we are already doing that. Pauline Avenue sewer line is in the process of being designed, and also some water pipelines in the 2nd Street area and Mary area, those areas, we're doing those pipelines. But as we talked about in, when we were doing our water rate study, we are planning to spend $1 million a year on water lines and $1 million a year on sewer lines for the next foreseeable years, 20, 30 years. We could, at this moment, as was mentioned earlier, that their water and sewer lines are in bad shape. That's true, and we could easily spend $100 million on that stuff. But what our plan is to spread it out over the years, spend $1 million a year on both each one. So we're already planning. We don't want to do a street, as was mentioned, and then have a water line break. We want to have the water lines and sewer lines in good shape before we do the streets, and that's a point we'll take it.
Well, the item in front of you tonight is to update our 5-year road projects. Back in November of 2018, we were fortunate enough to bond our Measure D funds along with the City of Calipat and the City of Hopeville. So for the next 3 years, we have approximately $11.5 million to do a lot of road improvements. So every year we have to provide with the auditors an updated list. So that's why we're presenting it to you tonight.
Thank you. I'm noticing we also have some bridges, Mr. Dale. Mm-hmm.
And they're on that list, yes.
Yes, I think we need to on 2nd Street and on Cloak. Yep. And
yep.
Yes, mm-hmm. Very good. 11.5, we need to use the money, Ms. Palomita.
Yes, actually today, the project inspector and our engineering technician, we sat down today and we have a list that's gonna come up. Our project right now is estimate 6.5 for 2019.
Beautiful. I like that. Mm-hmm. City is moving in the right direction.
Right.
Any questions? Is there a motion to accept this?
Motion to approve.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. Item 9 is passed. Item 10. You still here? There you go. Any questions? Anybody on this item?
Mr. Kim?
Put a guest.
I believe I spoke a while ago, and last couple of years when speaking, when you spending major team money, or when you have the road work, we need to take care of our water and sewer. Unfortunately, what I heard, the Cesar Chavez Boulevard, they ignored it, they just did it, paved it, and water line broke it. So they have to digging again, we have to spend money again. Mm-hmm. It's our city is supposedly proactive, but I think it's even they're not preventing our accidents. They had the money and time and idea, and they're not pursuing. And we're wasting a lot of money and time. I'm suspect, and this amount of the money increasement that might be caused by that. But so ever, whether this is the amount of the money or not, that's another proof. We now are not working for our tax dollars to working better. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kim. Mr. Dale, any comments on Ms. Palomita?
Any questions?
Yeah. Oh. Were you going to present a little?
Okay.
Yes, we are requesting that the City Council authorize the City Manager to sign change order number 3 with Pyramid Construction, who is currently the main general contractor for our Cesar Chavez project. The change order includes various items. One of the items that we're including is to add a chain link fence on the east side of Cesar Chavez along the railroad. Mm-hmm. Even before we started construction, we got a lot of concerned residents of Calexico saying that children as well as adults were crossing the railroads in areas where it was not appropriate for them, and it was a safety concern. Also, The next item is also to purchase K-rails. The original scope of the project was to install a medium along Cesar Chavez, but now we removed that item and want to purchase K-rails. So in case in the future, right now we have from 98 to Grant, there's going to be two lanes going south and two lanes going north. And then from Grant to 2nd Street, three lanes going south and two going north. So if in the future there's any changes, then we can just change the K-rails.
You can move them around.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It's those heavy concrete blocks that we use to separate.
Like in Mexicali.
Right. And then the third item is changing the LED, well, changing the lights on the signal light from sodium to LED and making them energy efficient.
And brighter?
Yes, mm-hmm. Brighter, much brighter.
Okay. And of course, Mr. Dale, the money here has already been earmarked and it's surplus monies.
Yeah, we were fortunate enough to get low bid on the project. The engineer's estimate was $7 million, and it came in at $6 million, which gives us a little leeway to enhance the project, the aesthetics, and also how the project actually comes out at the end.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Any questions for anybody?
I have one, Mr. Mayor.
Okay.
And it was addressed to me by one of the constituents of Calexico. Along Cesar Chavez, are we going to have curbside curbing for parking?
Yes. On the west side, where the residential area will have parking areas. But on the south of Grant, it'll be a through lane for local traffic only. Okay.
Another question, Mr. Dale and Ms. Falomir. Bike lanes, are there going to be any identified bike lanes?
Bike lanes north and south. Oh, I'm sorry to steal your thunder.
Start from 98 all the way down?
Yes.
Yes.
Uh-huh. With the widening of 98, there's already a bike lane, so it will connect to Cesar Chavez.
Mr. Gale, I think we discussed it from 98 to Grant. The concern were you saying about there's going to be parking, but it's going to be hard for them to get out because there's some residents there that they don't have an alley. I think we looked at it. There was about two or four residents that don't have an alley. So that's something that I asked Mr. Dale to look into.
Yep. We may lose a few parking spaces, but we're going to look into that.
Okay, good.
Okay. Call for the question.
Motion to approve item 10.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you, Ms. Palomita. Thank you.
Not done yet.
Item 11. Award the bid process from Pyramid Construction to Aggregate Inc. in the amount of $760,994.58 and authorize city manager to sign an agreement between the City of Calexico and Pyramid Construction and Aggregate Inc. for the Las Flores Street Improvement and Federal Project number CML 5168-030. Mr. Dale?
Mayor. Well,
Mr. Mayor?
I have a speaker.
Oh.
Another one?
Mm-hmm. Mr. Kim?
Senor Kim. Come on down.
This company, I believe that the company is same to the older shady pavement in the city of Calexico right now. And now you guys are trying to hire again. It's up to you guys to hire again or not, but we have to have right service and right condition of the street. That's our best interest for the citizens. And I believe City of Calexico was failed to supervising in their jobs. Or they intend, they don't have a more technician than that. And I've been seeing a lot of the asphalt, stone, black stone goes around the street and patches and the Cesar Chavez Boulevard and Cesar Chavez Zapata Street and the Las Flores. I seen a lot of different areas. It's very policy jobs. So I'm pleased to reconsider on this company. If you guys have to come higher, you better be in the better their supervising their workmanship. We spend tax dollar money, it's not free. And we have to watch our money and
good condition for our service for the citizens. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Palomita, notice we had some bids out here for this project.
Yes, we went out to bid and we received two bids, one from Pyramid Construction, which was the lowest bidder, and the second was Granite Construction. And just to clarify a little bit, our 2018 street improvement project is not being done by Pyramid Construction. It's another general contractor that will begin working on the streets again in March once the temperature
gets a little warmer.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, any comments from the board? Is there a motion to accept?
I'll make the motion to accept, Mr. Mayor.
Second.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Thank you. All passed. Item 12, discussion of potential action regarding request for waiver of sewer lateral replacement inside city right-of-way at 1025 Pauline Avenue. Mrs. Garcia.
Mr. Kim?
Mr. Kim.
Besides this one, I have one more to go. But again, the Pauline and Rockwood, little rains flood the street and blocking the traffic. And was changed our city in that way. And this time, whatever you guys are trying to do, the waiver of the right of the way, but to make sure our drain system works better, at least for that position. And the future, we need to looking into the Pauline and Rockwood. They have a big problem with our drain system, drain line. So please consider on that one. Thank you.
Mr. Dale, any comments on this project?
Yes, this particular segment of sewer line is already scheduled to be replaced. When the city replaces the sewer line, we also replace the laterals up to the property line. And what's happening right here is this particular sewer lateral has failed and needs to be replaced. Our code isn't clear in terms of who's responsible for a sewer lateral. In the water laterals, it's very clear that the water lateral is the city's responsibility up to the property line. And so what I would request the councils to consider waiving the fee for the city to replace this lateral on an emergency basis, and in the meantime, after this meeting, we'll be working on a code to bring to council to make this more clear.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you have it in the books?
Yeah.
There you go. Okay. Any questions for Mr. Dale?
No.
And this is coming from the enterprise fund, so it's not going to affect any other.
Correct.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All those in favor? Any questions for Mr. Dale?
No. Okay. Motion to approve item number 12.
Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Pass. Item 13. Discussion of potential action regarding requests for waiver of water and sewer late fees and extended due dates for water sewer bills for federal workers affected by the partial federal government shutdown. Mr. Dale.
Sir.
Any public comments?
We have another comment?
We have two.
Two comments. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Actually, Mr. Ismael Lopez is on, so just Mr. Kim.
Mr. Kim.
I believe our city tried to nice with the federal workers. Of course, they need the help. But it's not only a way for the AP. Why not to wait until their water bill payments? If they need it, we can give them the more extended time to pay the water bill in time after they got the paycheck. I like to see council included about the payment water bill to defer until they got the paycheck. After paycheck, probably they can pay about 2-3 months and the whatever they owe to the city. I'd like to city council consider to extend their due date of the water bill, not only late fees, so they can have a little financial relief. Thank you.
I think, Mr. Dale, we're allowing them 60 days.
Yes. At this point, it's 60 days, but we can always extend it if necessary.
Work with our...
Yes. Yeah. And to be clear, this is just waiving the late fees only, so there's really no impact to the city other than, you know, the $13.
It's a good thing in our gesture to
do this.
Right.
Assist any way we can with the shutdown with our...
A lot of families are suffering.
That's true.
All other cities are doing it.
Mm-hmm. I think so. Is there a motion to accept?
I'll make the motion to accept.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, thank you. Item 14. I'd like to personally take this one on. Discuss potential action regarding request for appoint delegate member and alternate member to the Southern California Association of Governments, SCAG, Regional Conference and General Assembly, May 2nd and 3rd, 2019 in Palm Desert, California. If there's no, I'd like to go to this as your acting mayor. That'll open up for discussion.
I just want to note that, let it be noted that I'm already on SCAG as a representative. How many we need?
I want to go.
So delegate, member, and alternate.
Could it be the alternate?
Yeah, I could be the alternate. There you go, Mr. Hodge. We can work this out.
We can work it out.
Why don't you send one of the new ones?
That's
a good
one.
Idea, too.
We'll be gone for 4 days.
There you go. This is just a two-dayer. Well, I'd like to throw my hat in the ring. Okay. And Mr. Hodge will be the alternate. Is that okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Is there a motion?
Motion to accept.
Second.
Thank you. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye, aye, sir.
Appointments by Council Member Hernandez to allow for her to name her commissions and boards and committees. I don't know if you're ready with names.
Yes, I am.
Oh, okay.
Awesome.
Okay, for Arts Commission, Library Board, Historic Commission, Hilde Carrillo. Planning Commission, Francisco Zarate. Police Commissioner, Daniel Buelna. Parks, Recreation, Beautiful and Senior Services Commissioner, Gabriel Duron. Personnel Commissioner, Olivia Valenzuela. BIT, Jesus Lopez. Sales Tax, Citizen Advisory Committee, Measure H, Jaime Duron. Economic Development and Financial Advisory Commission, Esther Gomez. And I would like to thank them all for accepting their positions.
Sorry, who was your personnel person again?
Okay.
Thank you for doing that.
Number 16.
Item 16, Union Long. This is under the Redevelopment Successor Agency. Adopt a resolution of the successor agency to the Community Redevelopment Agency of the City of Calexico, approving an agreement between the successor agency and Ferris Lee Investments, Inc. to list and to sell certain real property assets of the successor agency and approving certain related actions. Mr. Dale.
As a part of our the old redevelopment agency, the city, through their redevelopment agency, owned several pieces of property, and when the RDAs went out of with the state, we had to submit paperwork saying what is our plan for these, what is our long range plan for these properties, and our long range plan is to liquidate their properties. And so finally we are moving forward on this as per our plan, and we had an RFP sent out, we had interviews, I was not on the interview panel. But the selected firm was here as in front of you to start the process.
That's all we have listed, two properties that we need to get?
Correct. We have three properties, but the third one we're working on separately.
Oh, okay. So we need to get these properties off our hands and off our books.
Yes.
So the state can say that we are dealing with RDA funds and
so
property.
To be clear, this is not the approval of selling the properties. This is a just to approve
put them on the market, right?
Yes.
Yes.
it would still have, it still has to go to the oversight board at the county and all those kind of things, but yeah.
And again, there was a couple of companies that
interested in buying?
Were bidding or?
Well, we haven't gotten to that point yet, but we have some informal interest in properties already.
Okay. Mm. All right. Any questions for Mr. Dale?
Is there any option to maybe just, or while it's being sold, to where maybe it can be leased, just generate some type of income towards the city?
We are leasing one of the properties currently. The other property is vacant land. Okay. So there's nothing to lease on that one.
Now, the other question is there any opportunity where the city might be interested in doing some type of investment towards infrastructure or something that can maybe benefit in regards to, like I said, once again, lease, cash flow, well, something that can bring in some constant revenue towards the city with those properties?
There may be an opportunity that we could, at the city ourselves, could purchase one of the smaller pieces,
okay,
using the revenue from one of the bigger ones.
Mm-hmm. So. Okay. I just wanted to make sure it's not taken off the table.
Yes.
Even though we're going to put them out
yes,
for sale.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other question?
Motion to approve item 16.
Is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Thank you. Passed. Any items for future agenda? Mr. Romero, any item?
No, not at the moment.
Ms. Fernandez?
No.
Mr. Hodge?
No, it'll take me forever to find it, so I'll
okay.
wait next time.
Motion to adjourn.
All right. All those in favor of adjourning?
Aye.
Aye.
Adjourned. Thank you.
I'd like to